never been a fucking hater in my fucking life. I represent real bitches.
I ain't gonna lie, I'm a little slash.
Brooklyn, make some fucking noise. Young and May.
We in the club, man. Yeah, they hate, but they broke them. And when it's time to pop, they had no
shit.
Yeah, I'm pretty, but I'm loco.
Yeah, I'm loco.
The loud got me moving.
You gon' make me pop up at your door like surprise. Now come outside, little bitch. Yeah, what the fuck is good? And then wait.
Okay, guys, hi, this is Tasha, Tasha Talk Truth, where y'all already know Tasha Talk Truth all day, every day. So let's get into it. Okay, guys, you gotta excuse my voice. I am sick, so y'all please bear with me. And also, this is my first time, well, not my first time, but just a couple of times that I had did a voiceover. So, guys, I wanted to talk about what's been going on with Nicki Minaj and Cardi B. Now, we all know that it was just a big old blast of everything that happened last weekend, guys, and we all know it was just back and forth, and there are some things that were true, there are some things that were false, but we don't know. We wasn't there at the hotel. We all just have to make our own opinion on what happened. But what thing that I do want to say is these women were able to say at the end, you know what, let's keep it positive and let's keep it moving. And that's what they did. You know, the thing about it is that I can't believe that Remy Ma actually is hating on these two girls, and I really think she's hating on Cardi B. It's because now that they have moved on, you know, it's just like, wow, the beef is over. Well, we don't know if the beef is really over, but right now we think it's over, and Remy Ma is not in a good place with that. You know, because what happened is when Remy Ma did Sheether, you know, and she laid down, it was like, well, Cardi B was next in line to attack Nicki for her. So only thing she had to do was sit back and watch the drama unfold. But now that these girls said, you know, we're not doing this anymore for now, you know, if Remy Ma feels some type of way about that, you know. So the thing about it is Nicki Minaj had called Cardi B ass out on her radio show and had said, baby,
you asked me to be on your second single. My manager, G. Roberson, is right here. Didn't you speak to, what's the nigga name, first manager, G? What's his name? Shaft. You asked me to be on your second single, and I said no, because I feel like it's too much, because Motorsport was about to come out. Now you acting like you lovey-dovey with them girls. Why you ain't asked Remy and Kim to be on your single, baby girl?
Girl, you wanted me to be on your second single. I refuse to, but why didn't you go to any of your other girls? Why didn't you have Remy or Kim on your album, period? You know, why didn't you have them on there, period? Them your girls? So she really called Cardi BS out on that. And you know what? I think, and I guarantee you, Remy Ma had some kind of feelings about that, because I guarantee you that it was already in Remy Ma's head, you know, damn, this girl done blew up. She didn't even ask me to collaborate with her, but I brought her out on stage. You see, Remy Ma is a hater. That's exactly what she is. She's a hater. She picked with Nicki. You know, before she even got out of jail, she told Nicki, you know what? I'm going to say I'm the queen of rap, but I ain't talking about you. Really, Remy? Really, Remy? I don't care for Remy at all, because she's fake. She's a bully. And, you know, it is what it is. She picked with Nicki. She picked with Nicki. She picked with Nicki. But the thing about it is, okay, you know, why she was so busy worrying about what Nicki was doing and trying to stop Nicki's career and her bag. Cardi B was doing cartwheels around Remy Ma ass, and she blew up to this mega star while Remy Ma ass was still sitting there worried about Nicki, talking about Nicki was good on the VMAs, and what happened? Her fucking music career didn't go no fucking where. She left Fat Joe, and her shit still didn't do good. And so what did she have to do? She had to go back on love and hip-hop. That's what she had to do. And I call her Rent-A-My. 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 That's what I call her. But you know what? The thing about it is, it was just really, really sad that these women, you know, tried to, you know, squash the beef. And coming from Remy Ma, the lady who brought all these mega stars, Queen Latifah, MC Light, Moni Love, you know, brought all these stars on stage at Summer Jam and paying homage to these female rappers. And you're telling me that she's upset and calling them corny because they made up? Oh, wow. That shows you that Remy Ma is a hater. And I already knew Remy Ma was a hater. Oh, well, Rent-A-My was a hater. But you know what? This is the thing, and this is what she said in her clip on her show with Joe Budden, on her show, State of the Culture. And this is what she had to say.
I'll be like this.
Uninterested.
Couldn't have been me. I'm different. Like, I'm not gonna keep arguing with somebody.
It's different.
I don't wanna hear this. Like, I don't wanna hear anything. And I think the part that made it the corniest after everything for like a whole 15 hours, and then they're both like, okay, let's be friends now.
That's why it was great. You had. But that's not, why it was I'm great. They aired that. All the dirty laundry and said, it's no beef. I bet. No, it ain't no beef now. Like they told all my beef.
I'm over it. Scotty's over it. Joe, you know your ass is over it too. Stop it.
Well, I'm over it because they both are fronting like they're over it, so we have to support women.
Yeah, back like we're over it, so.
Well, I'm be the only nigga.
We gotta fight.
No, if y'all think it's over, it's over.
And then after that, you know, you can see the haterism. You can see the hate in her eyes. You can see the jealousy all over her face. You can see it. You can see it. And you know what? It's really sad. It's really sad. You know, so the thing about it is, Remy Ma, if you have a problem, you need to take it up with Cardi B. Because you brought Cardi B out on stage, and Cardi B did not even pay homage back to your ass. She didn't even put you on her fucking album. And you know what? The thing about it is, I always, you know, said that, like, I cannot believe that Cardi B didn't even have Remy Ma on her album. You know why? Because she wanted to be the newest hot female rapper. She didn't want no other female rapper on her fucking album because she did not have no... She could have collaborated with Remy Ma. She could have collaborated with Remy Ma and Lil' Kim. She could have even put Mariah Lynn on there. She put none of you females, none of you females on her fucking album. But you know what? They want to go and attack Nicki. They want to go and attack Nicki for not doing the same thing. Really? Really, Remy? Because you blew that up about Nicki. That, oh, she wanted to be the only female rapper out here. That's why she didn't even collaborate. Well, how many female rappers do she have on her album? How many did she ever collab? Okay, well, how many did Nicki? I mean, how many did Cardi B have on there? None. Zero, zip, nada. Okay, but I don't see nobody throwing Cardi B up on the bus. And that's the thing, you know, that's the thing. I sympathize with Nicki because Nicki always says that, you know, it's a hate train for her. And it's absolutely a hate train for her. You know, it's just period. Cardi B gets away with so much bullshit It's pathetic. But you know what? I'm gonna leave that. I'm gonna leave that alone because these girls have not made up, but they're acting civilized out here in the world, like they should be. But another thing is, Remy Ma, you need to address Cardi B. We're going to see how you're going to address Cardi B. And vice versa. Cardi B, we're going to see how you're going to address Remy Ma for calling you corny. Okay? Because you show will go in on Nicki Minaj when she likes a tweet or when her fans say something about you, but this came out of Remy Ma mouth herself. She called you corny. So we're going to see how Cardi B is going to address. You know what? Her music career is over. Remy Ma is throwing a towel. You know, you are not a good entertainer. You are not an artist. You know, you a battle rapper, like they say. You are not an artist. So go ahead, hang the gloves up for that, and go ahead and do what you do best. And that is reality TV. That is where you are needed. They're renting you. So that's what's going on. All right, guys. What do y'all think about Remy Ma calling Nicki Minaj and Cardi B corny? What do you think about this woman who attacked, drugged Nicki, and also spoke about that she do not rap with female artists, female rappers. Let me rephrase that, female rappers. But Cardi B has done the same thing, and she has not said a word to Cardi B. But now that Cardi B and Nicki Minaj shook hands in so many words, now both of them corny. You know what, guys? People are so funny. Women is funny. They really are. They are really funny. I tell you, they are funny. So, guys, don't forget, subscribe to my channel. Like, leave a comment, or even share the video. Just tell me what y'all think about Remy Ma once again calling Cardi B corny and Nicki Minaj shook hands in so many words. Now both of them corny. You know what, guys? People are so funny. Women is funny. They really are. They are really funny. I tell you, they are funny. So, guys, don't forget, subscribe to my channel. Like, leave a comment, or even share the video. Just tell me what y'all think about Remy Ma once again calling Cardi B corny and Nicki Minaj corny because she did not get on, she didn't get a collaboration on the number one female, which is Cardi B in a hip hop. She didn't get a feature on her album, but she sure brought her out on stage. She brought her out on stage. You know, that's what happens. And the thing about it is, let me say this, because I always said this about Nicki. Female rappers do not have to make somebody else's career for them. They do not have to. I was really strong, and I was really against people were saying that Nicki Minaj, especially Minaj, Nicki Minaj didn't pay homage. Nicki Minaj, who did else, what other female has she rapped with? What other female has she rapped with? So what? Nicki Minaj don't have to rap with any other female. She don't have to build somebody else's career for them. She don't have to. Period. She does not have to. And Remy Ma, you so worried about that, well, go after Cardi B. Because Cardi B did not put your ass on her fucking album. And Nicki Minaj even backed that up. And we're going to roll that clip now. Peace.
You asked me to be on your second single. My manager, G. Roperson, is right here. Didn't you speak to, what's the nigga name, first manager of G? What's his name? Shaft. You asked me to be on your second single, and I said no because I feel like it's too much because Motorsport was about to come out. Now you acting like you lovey-dovey with them girls. Why you ain't asked Remy and Kim to be on your single, baby girl? Brrr.
stop the bags. Huh?
Hey, y'all. So let's talk about last night, because last night was an epic night for me. You know what I'm saying? Even though I didn't win no awards, but you know what I'm saying? It's cool, though, because the people that did win, they definitely deserve it. Shout out to Remy Ma. She contributed to one of the biggest moments in my life, which is going off on Summer Jam stage. You know, she had to bring me out, but she did bring me out. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to her for that. You know what I'm saying? That was real boo. You know what I'm saying? But I just want to say thank you, everybody, that has seen me blossom into a butterfly. You know what I'm saying? I went from a roach to a butterfly. And I just want to thank to all my friends and my family. Each and every one of them sent me beautiful paragraphs, and all of them posted me up. A lot of them called me tearing up. And I was like, don't cry for me. Cry for Jesus. You know what I'm saying? You know, my mama and my daddy, they so proud of me, because all their family and their friends keep calling. They're like, oh my God, we saw your daughter on TV. And it's just like, this is a very big, important moment for me, you know what I mean?
And vice versa. Cardi B, we're going to see how you're going to address Remy Ma for calling you corny, okay? Because you sure will go in on Nicki Minaj when she likes a tweet, or when her fans say something about you. But this came out of Remy Ma's mouth herself. She called you corny. So we're going to see how Cardi B is going to address Remy Ma for calling her corny. Because I don't even think that Cardi B, did she clap? Have she clapped back on Remy Ma? No, I don't think so. But you know what? Remy Ma is a bully. She's a hater. And I really don't care for Remy Ma. You know, yes, I understand she had a second chance at life. You know, a second chance out here because, you know, she went to prison and things like that. You know, but that's the thing. She should be, you know, trying to tell these women, you know, to stop beefing with each other. But you know what? She did not one thing. She did such thing with these two women because she sat back. She thought it was entertaining because she had a hate for Nicki. So she watched Cardi B go after Nicki so she can sit back and do what she do. But you know what? Her music career is over.